Hi DIYers, Sterling from Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to install a 5828 wireless keypad. This is actually a 5828V wireless keypad. Both keypads are very similar. The only difference is that the V, this version, has voice annunciation. So there's a microphone in the corner. You can record messages to this for playback for your family. Or the voice is great for voice annunciation. So when a door chimes, instead of just seeing the two-digit zone number that faults, it'll actually speak the zone descriptor that you've got programmed into your system. We have our 5828V programmed to our Lynx Touch L5100 wireless security system, which is installed downstairs. And the 5828V that we're going to install here, we're up in the master bedroom, gives us a second point of system control so that we can arm and disarm right before we go to bed or right after we wake up. That way we don't have to run downstairs and use the system. We get a lot of questions about adding a Lynx Touch to a Lynx Touch. A lot of people want a secondary touchscreen keypad. Unfortunately, that's not possible. As an all-in-one wireless system, because it's a control panel and a keypad, you can't learn a system to a system. So the 5828V or the 5828 are your only real options for secondary system controllers. So now that we've gone through why you would add one of these, we're going to show you how to install it. First thing you want to do, on the back, there is a backplate. This little tab, if you push in or just simply pull out a little bit, it slides down. So there are tabs, four tabs on the backplate. They line up with the four holes on the back of the keypad. So insert it, you got your backplate. Again, pull it out a little bit, slide it down, it snaps off. This allows us to mount our backplate on the wall and then simply slide our keypad in and on. So another thing I want to highlight, comes with three AA batteries. We've already installed them. We have this little plastic cover to cover this up. Simply snaps into place and backplate, we're good to go. So some tools we'll need for this installation. A level, make sure we keep it nice and neat. We have three screws. It actually comes with four, we're just gonna use three. It did not come with wall anchors, so we have some wall anchors for our drywall here. And Phillips head screwdriver. Finally, power drill with a 1/8 drill bit. So we've got our backplate, and if you can see, we have a Z-Wave thermostat that we also have paired to our Lynx Touch. So we're going to use this to properly align our mounting location for our keypad. Finally, we have a pen which will allow us to mark our holes, prepare us for our drilling. I'm going to take my level, and we'll talk about why we're doing this later, but we're going to mount directly over this power outlet. It is a wireless keypad, runs off of batteries only. We're going to show you why it's good to add an AC transformer for power all the time, and that's why we want to mount it directly over that. So I've got my mounting plate, I'm centering over my wall outlet, and we take our keypad, actually. Since the wall plate is a little bit smaller than the keypad, I'm going to align my keypad on the wall in line with my ZW stat till it's level, centered directly over the outlet, and I'm going to mark my line here. Now I can pop my backplate off. I've got my mark, and you can see on the back plate you've got three holes along the top, three holes along the bottom. We're going to use two on the top, one centered on the bottom. So get it aligned, and we're just going to simply drill our holes. Ooh. Now that we've got our holes drilled, we're going to put our wall anchors in so that we can screw in our screws. Just going to use the back of my screwdriver to knock that wall anchor in. Put in number two. And then the final one at the bottom. Wall anchors are in and tight. Flush with the wall. Take our three screws, one at a time. Got our back plate. Screw it down, not all the way. Give it some play so that we can get it tight. Make sure it's in place properly. Screw number one. Screw number two. And our final screw at the bottom. Since this is our last one, we can screw it down nice and tight and then get back over to these. Screw them down. Now that we have our back plate secure, all we really need to do, align the holes with the keypad, slide it down into place, flip open the panel, wake the keypad up.
It's on, ready to arm.
We're ready to go to arm the system.
Arm away, exit now.
I heard the system downstairs beep to arm. Keypad shows armed away, good to go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Default master code and then off, system is disarmed. So that would be how to install the 5828V using the batteries only. As I mentioned before, this system, or keypad rather, when on batteries only, will work. So to preserve the battery life, because it only uses just three regular AA alkalines, to prevent you from having to change your batteries every week, it goes to sleep mode. It's already gone to sleep since the last time I pressed the button. Gives you an idea of how quickly it'll go to sleep. One disadvantage of the sleep mode to preserve the battery is the fact that this keypad will not wake up by pressing a button, as you would expect. The only way to wake it up is to press the star key. You press and hold.
It's on. Ready to arm.
Voice turns on, shows AC in the corner that it's got power, shows chime, because we have chime mode on. If a door would open, it would chime. But again, as soon as we let it go for roughly 15 seconds, it's going to go back and the screen will time out and no button presses will do anything. So the disadvantage, and not so important maybe up in the master bedroom, but if you had this at your front door and you had your Lynx Touch positioned away from the front door, one disadvantage would be that you come home, you open your entry exit door, you would expect this to wake up to prompt you to disarm your system. It does not do that, unfortunately. So you would have a very good chance of having a false alarm and forgetting that your system is armed because you have nothing beeping at you as you enter. And that's why many people like to use the K0991 transformer. It's an AC transformer. I've got it right here. It's a 5 volt, 220 milliamp power supply. And it's got a DC connector on one end, simple power supply on the other, and you can plug this into the back of the keypad. It would still use the batteries for the time when the power to the house, like for instance power outage, or any reason that the outlet may be turned off, the batteries would still work, the keypad would still work. But when this is installed correctly, then the system or the keypad would stay awake at all times. That way when you open your door, it'll chime immediately. If you ever need to come over and use the keypad, you don't have to worry about pressing the star key to wake it up. So we're now going to show you how adding this makes it a much better keypad. Slide it up to get it off the back plate. You can see on the back that there are wire tracks off the side or underneath. Because we conveniently powered it installed it right over this outlet, we're going to use the bottom wire track. So we're going to thread the wire through here, up to the left, and then the DC plug-in is right up into there. Snap it in place. And now we have our convenient AC adapter. Mount the keypad in place. Unplug our drill, plug in the power adapter.
It's on. Ready to on.
And you can see, with it plugged in, I did not even have to press the star key. Keypad woke back up. It will never go to sleep as long as there's power feeding to it. So obviously this wire, many people are going to complain about having a wire hanging down. It'd be very simple to fish the wire. You poke a little hole above the outlet, run the wire up behind the keypad. You'll notice on the back of the back plate, there's a special hole meant directly for pulling the wire through. If you want to see how to fish a wire, check out our L5100 Lynx Touch installation video, because we showed you how to fish a wire for the LT cable for the same very purpose. So I'm not going to show you that right now, but check out that video and you'll see. Another popular option, if you don't want to deal with the whole wire fish, is to just run this wire taut to the bottom and just run a little bit of wire track to hide this wire. Now we have a nice looking keypad and a great way to arm and disarm our Lynx Touch system from a remote location. So if you have any questions on how to install or use a 5828V, please let us know in the comments below, and make sure to subscribe to our channel for all future videos.